second base. We'll explain more on that in just a moment. Chip Carey, Jeff Francoeur, great to be back with you at the ballpark after Atlanta won 10-1 last night. Some roster moves were announced by the Braves today. Matt Adams had to go to the injured list. Ozzie Albies, sore wrist, also had to go to the injured list. That means Charlie Culberson gets the start for Atlanta today. And also, Jeff, no Freddie Freeman. With those roster moves, though, Alex Jackson is back from the minor league camp, and Nick Markakis is back all of a sudden.
Yeah, this one excites me. Your team leader's back, one of your main cogs. And, you know, I talked to Nick for a minute today, and he said, look, I missed the guys. It was tough watching them on TV, seeing them. And you know what? I think he's going to be ready to go. I think he'll be in there tomorrow night, and might see him get in there tonight, but be fun to see him back in the lineup.
Speaking of fun, the Braves offense exploded. 10 more runs last night. I know Sean Newcomb would like that kind of run support tonight, but quite frankly, third start for Sean, this is another big opportunity.
It is, and Sean's talked about how he wanted to get back in the starting rotation. Had a great year last year in the pen. We thought he really matured, learned how to kind of command the zone. Well, this year, the biggest thing for him is going to be that fastball command. And, you know, last year, 65% fastballs. This year, only 54. I'd like to see him be able to get ahead with that and then let those other pitches work. It's what he did out of the pen last year. And for him, it's the same recipe. You're just starting now. So go out there and do what you do.
Win the inning, and hopefully the Braves can win game two. Atlanta's offense has been unbelievably good, and the Braves' catcher's core, yes, all four of them, have been unlikely heroes. We will come back and take it. Goes to work against Charlie Montoyo's Toronto club, which starts play tonight. 3 wins, 5 losses. Their Toyota starting nine, pretty much the same thing we saw last night. Jays didn't get much going offensively in game one. Just 1 run, 5 hits, but a bit of a pass. They had 5 days off between games due to the COVID scheduling issues that many in baseball have faced. But Sean Newcomb doesn't care about that. He cares about taking this game deep and solidifying his spot in rotation, Jeff.
Yeah, and Sean, I tell you, it's simple tonight, Chip. If he can establish a fastball, get ahead in the count, this guy can go 6-7 innings and be the guy that we know he can be. If he gets behind, it's tough.
That sounds like a Ford key to me. Am I right?
Yeah. Get ahead. Throw first pitch strike tonight and let your stuff work. Keep Pinjin Ryu winless. Hasn't got his first win for the Blue Jays. And last, Riley Camargo.
Toyota, Acuna, Swanson, Ozuna third. Freddie Freeman gets the total night off tonight. Darnold, the cleanup man. Duvall, Riley at first base. Charlie Culberson gets the start at second. And it's Ender Inciarte, not Ozzie Albies, in center field facing Pinjin Ryu. Big money import for Toronto, formerly with the Dodgers.
Yeah, 4 years, $80 million this offseason. Bringing him in to be their ace. You see that last year, even though that's a great second half, still not what he was the first half. They're looking for big things and for him to have a bounce back outing after his last one.
Last two haven't been all that good, quite frankly. Hasn't gotten out of the fifth inning yet. 8 earned runs in 9 innings.
And he will throw 4 pitches at any time. Fastball, cutter, changeup.